I just can't even appreciate that, you know. You may be a Pharisee, but you don't even know it, you feel me? So today, I'll say we got my family, my cousins, we got a debate about, you know, spiritual awareness, you know, religion, spirit of religion, all that stuff, you know, talking about the vaccine, you know. Yeah, I was the one who was getting opposed, you know. And now, you know, I'm not saying what I said was wrong. I'm saying the way what I did and how I said it was wrong, you know. And us, you know, as Christians, you know, we tend to think we're always in the right, you feel me? We tend to think that, you know, we're always, you know, just perfect, you know. But we should know that we're not perfect, you know. We still make mistakes, and we should still be open to rebukes and correction, not to hurt us, but to make us better, you know, more like Christ, you know. And so today, you know, they were saying, you know, they were like saying you're trying to be perfect and all stuff. And I was like, you know, am I really? I'm not really trying to give that impression. But when you don't preach the word of God, you know, when you not necessarily preach the word of God, but when you don't ask the Holy Spirit what to say, when you want to take control of the preaching, it's going to go wrong because it's not the way the Holy Spirit intended it to go to, you know. It's like you trying to go to someone's house, right? You know, let's say, you know, I tell you, I'll go down this road and then take a left. But instead, you take a south. I mean, no, my fault. I don't know why I said south. You take a right instead of a left when you go down the road and get yourself in an accident, you know. Disobeying God will never lead you into a good situation. Sometimes it could, but only in the world's eyes, you know, only in society's eyes, you know, but that thing will lead you to your demise in hell, you know. Success is good, but, you know, sometimes Satan also awards you success. He awards sin with success, you know, not all the times, but sometimes, you feel me? But let me go back. As I was, you know, appreciating all stuff and trying to, like, prove my point, you know, I was just, like, getting emotional. I was getting frustrated. I was like, come on, why can't they, you know, why can't they just do this? Why can't they just do that? And me trying to grow the seed, me trying to just, like, change them, that doesn't work, you know? I'm basically saying that, God, your ways, your time is incorrect. It's my time. I want them to do it now. I want them to change now. But, nah, God said, nah, listen to me, son. You know, my time's perfect. You know, my agenda is not your agenda, you know. Apostle Peter talks about how one day is 1,000 days to God, and 1,000 days is one day, I believe. I'm not sure, you know. Correct me if I'm wrong, you feel me? But that's how it is, you know. When, you know, God's time is the best, you know, no matter how frustrating it may be. And God calls us to be patient because he was patient with us, you know. So let us be patient with others, you feel me, you know. So that's how I was just like, you know, and I just went outside. I was like crying, and she's like, bro, I was crying out of frustration, you know. And I was like, I felt offended because I was the one being opposed. Little did I know, not because of what I said, I mean, not because of my message, I mean, kinda, but it was mainly because of how I reacted to the opposition, you know. When my mom was telling me, you know, when you go out to evangelize, you know, it's not going to be a piece of cake, you feel me? It's not going to be like, you know, it's not like you're preaching to little children most of the time. Because if you're preaching to someone who's like a child, when you're preaching to a child, you know, they're going to easily believe it. You know, children, they take, you know, they take everything to heart, you know, so it's hard to, you know, it's hard to change their minds. That's the same thing. That's why Jesus says, be like a child, you know, for this is the kingdom of God, you know. So, you know, we have to be, you know, we have to be like children, you know. We have to be, you know, immature. And like when Jesus tells us to be like a child, you know, my mom also said, you know, it's hard to teach someone with like a lot of years of experience that, oh, this, you know, this, like, this and that, oh, it's not this way, oh, you've been doing it the wrong way the whole time. They're not going to believe that. You know, you've ever heard the saying, you can't teach an old dog new tricks, you know. It's hard because they're stubborn, you know. and prideful, but it doesn't make you right, you feel me? We have to watch the way we, you know, just, you know, react. And, like, you know, whenever, like, it was for like a week, you know, maybe even 2 weeks, you know, I was just feeling like my days have been terrible. I've been kind of like not necessarily judging people for how they look, not anything. I'm just like, man, why do people do this? Like, I complain. I'm like, I'm basically, you know, glorifying the enemy, but am I doing anything about it? No, I'm not doing nothing about it, you know, and because of some things that's been going on in my life, you know. But I just been complaining, but, you know, I need to, instead of complaining, more of praying than complaining. There shouldn't be any complaining at all. You know, Philippians 2:14, do everything without grumbling or arguing, I believe. Not sure. Correct me if I'm wrong, you feel me? But yeah, you know, that's what God's called us to do, you feel me? So that's, you know, and when you get too, like, serious, you know, how I was, you know, you can easily get offended, you know, and things can turn out the wrong way, you know, because the way the Holy Spirit never intended it to go, you feel me? That's when we need to follow God's way, you know, and take his principles to heart, you know? Yeah, you know, we gotta meditate on his precepts, you know, meditate on his principles, you know, and then, you know, we gotta fix our eyes on the Lord, you know, not what people have to say about us, you know. Let's not take it to heart. Apostle Paul even said himself that he cared about what the religious leader said, what he wouldn't even be preaching, you know. And the same thing with Jesus. I'm pretty sure it's the same thing for a lot of, you know, preachers, you know. If they care what people say, you know, they wouldn't be preaching, you know. But now we shouldn't care about what people say about us, you know. But at the same time, we should also have the right approach, you know, the approach God tells us to take. We shouldn't follow our own fleshly disease. We shouldn't decide by the flesh. We shouldn't follow what the flesh tells us to do, because it'll only lead to our demise. And instead of bringing understanding, instead of preaching the message, it's just gonna cause division and strife, like not godly division, you know, like Jesus was saying. And I believe Luke 9:39, where he was talking about how he didn't come to bring peace, you know, but division, because his word brings division. But it should be preached the right way, or else, you know, it could have been brought to bring understanding, but instead it brought division, you know. And, like, you know, when you're like a Pharisee, you know, the fruits you bear are terrible, you know. You shouldn't only try to look good on the outside, but we should also be clean on the inside as well, you know. You know, and it's not only about, you know, how everyone sees us, but it's about what our thoughts are looking like, you know, how we think, you know, what we do, you know, how we react to things, you know. Those are things God really cares about. I mean, he doesn't look on the outside, looks on the inside. Same thing with King David. I mean, yeah, David, before he was anointed as king, you know, God didn't look on the outside. You know, he may have been scrawny, may have been small. God don't care. You know, he chose him as king because he knew he had the right heart, you feel me? And so that's how it is, you feel me? You just gotta stay humble, you know, just listen to what people have to say. Have the right approach, have discernment. You know, when you have this Holy Spirit and we have a relationship with him, he will let you know what you need to say. He'll give you words of knowledge, you know. He'll give you discernment, you know. He'll give you wisdom. And one thing I also do, guys, say is, you know, also think about that person. If you know that person that you're trying to talk to, think about their past. Think of what they've gone through. Think of their experiences, because that'll help you for your approach and what you have to say, you know. Because you can go full on, like, saying the wrong thing, and not necessarily condemning them, but, like, just, like, you know, putting so much pressure on them, because, you know, they're going to fight back, you know, they're going to be defensive, and that's just natural human, you know, reactions, you feel me? But God has given us the power to overcome them. But even still, it's hard, you know, it's hard to overcome them. But, you know, let me not, you know, let you think that there's no temptation you can overcome. You can't overcome, because God says he's provided a way, you feel me? So, yeah, you know, we have to be careful, so that, you know, let's not get too serious, you know, to the point where we're not bearing good fruits, you know, love, joy, peace, faithfulness, you know, kindness, gentleness, goodness, you know, self-control, you know. We need to be bearing the good fruits, you know. We shouldn't, you know, cause division, you know, like not in an ungodly manner, you know, outside the will of God. You know, we shouldn't be so self-centered. We need to be not necessarily selfless, but just be aware of how people, you know, like what people gone through, you know. Excuse me. Just be aware of like people's situations and what they're going through, you feel me? I mean, when we're doing deliverance, you know, revivals and all that stuff, whoever is doing the deliverance ask, you know, what have you come here for, you know? And then you would explain what you need, you know? And then the Holy Spirit will tell you how to go from there, you feel me? So that's just the message I had today, and it's my own personal experience, you know? And, you know, I've repented, you know? And it's called sanctification. You know, be asking the Holy Spirit to reveal sin in your life so that he'll quickly overcome that sin. You know, you'll overcome that sin, you know, and it'll be gone. One step closer to holiness, you feel me? Peace out. God bless.